science session. So let us continue with our chapter fiber to fabric. So in the last session we have discussed about the different types of fibers, that is animal fiber and plant fibers. So in that we are studying about the animal fibers. In animal fibers we have wool as well as silk. So in that we have discussed about the wool. So wool is obtained from the sheep, and we have studied that there are different breeds of sheep and they are found in the different regions which give different types of wools. So in this session we will study how the fiber is converted into wool, that is from fibers to the wool. So how the sheep are reared and how the we obtain the wool from the sheep. So the fleece that is covered over the sheep, which is nothing but the hair of the sheep, it is cut and it is processed into different process and the wool is obtained. So let us study about all this process in this session.
Raising of sheep for obtaining wool, meat, milk, skin and manure is called sheep farming or sheep rearing. People who rear sheep are called shepherds. Sheep has cover of hair on its body called fleece or fur. They obtain wool from fleece of the sheep. Sheep are herbivorous and they feed on grass. Shepherd take the sheep for grazing. They also feed the mixture of pulses, jawar, oil cakes and minerals to sheep. When winter starts, sheep are kept inside the shelter. Here, shepherd give them leaves, grains and dry fodder to eat. The advantages of sheep rearing is, sheep are strong animals and can live in much more severe environment. Therefore, they need little care and management. Sheep need little space for living. So many sheep can be kept in small area. They provide various products which provide very good income within short time. They help farmers by eating unwanted plants in farm, and here are some of the breeds in India along with their quality and states where they are found. And moreover, if you select parent having special characteristics, then it is possible to produce a sheep having those characteristics. This is called selective breeding. With the help of selective breeding, it is possible to produce sheep which provide good quality wool. Sheep rearing requires provision of facilities like plenty of clean and fresh water, availability of green foods such as grass, provision of medication facility as well as transportation and marketing facility. So sheep rearing is done in the areas where these facilities are available. In India, sheep rearing is done in the hilly areas of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. The sheep rearing is also done in the plains of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat.
You understood about the rearing and breeding of the sheep, but how the processing of the fiber is done to convert it into the wool, so that we have to know. So there are several steps where the fibers are converted into the wool. So like shearing, scouring and sorting and the drying of the fibers, and then dyeing is done and the fibers are again straightened. So there are so many process and steps where the processing of the fiber is done to get converted into wool. So let us study about all this process in this session.
We cannot use fibers obtained from sheep directly for making sweaters, shawls and many other things. Instead, these are processed in stepwise manner. Here in this session, we will learn how fiber are processed into wool. First step is shearing. The layer of hairs around the sheep body is called fleece. Shearing is the process of removing fleece and thin layer of skin from the sheep body. For this purpose, Tools similar to those used by barbers are used. The outer skin of animal body is dead, so shearing doesn't harm the sheep. However, this process must be done in hot weather, because if shearing is done in winter, then the climate would harm the sheep, since protective layer is not present. However, in hot weather, they can remain same even if there is no protective layer. After shearing, the skin rebuilds some days and hair starts growing again. Shearing provides fibers. Then, after shearing, the next step is scouring. The hairs, that is fibers obtained from shearing, contains dirt such as grease and dust. It must be removed before further processing. Thus, the sheared skin along with hair is washed thoroughly to remove dirt. It is called scouring. It is done by hand or by machines. It is then dried and sent to factories. Scouring provides clean fibers. After scouring, the next step is sorting. In this step, the clean fibers are taken to factories where they are separated according to the texture, such as length and color. The fine hairs are then used to make cloths, while coarse hair are used to make rugs. There are some fluffy fibers called burrs present in the fleece. These are removed and used as burrs on sweaters. The next step in processing wool is dyeing. The fibers are dyed, that is, colored according to the need. Since fibers are white, brown, and black naturally, therefore other colors are used for dyeing. After dyeing, the fibers are straightened, combed, and rolled into yarn. This is how woolen yarn is obtained. There are two types of fibers, longer fiber and shorter fiber. Longer fibers are used for making sweaters, while shorter fiber are used for making the woolen cloths.
I hope, children, in this session, you better understood about the processing of the fiber into the wool and how the rearing and breeding of the sheep is done and what are the advantages of rearing and breeding the sheep, okay, and what are the steps that are involved in processing of the wool. So everything you have studied in this session. Thank you.